Hello, dear students. I'm sure that you already clear the concept of different circumstances, different situations for goodwill at the time of admission of a new partner. Last time, we discussed different six methods. Which six? First, let's revise it very quickly, because if you understand the method properly, in that case only it's possible for you to make it very clear when you are going to solve it through practical questions like this. See, the number is not important. Okay, first one, when goodwill paid privately. Now we are talking about only goodwill entries at present, okay? When goodwill paid privately, no accounting entry for that goodwill. Second, when goodwill brought in cash. When goodwill brought in cash and retained in the form. At that time, two entries, one cash to goodwill, premium for goodwill rather, take care, and second, premium for goodwill to old partner's capital account. Third, when, again the same topic, goodwill brought in cash and important one, withdrawn by partners, old partners. When goodwill brought in cash and withdrawn by old partner. So here in that case, normal first two entries will remain same, that is cash to premium for goodwill and premium for goodwill to old partner's capital account. But one more entry, third entry added in that concept, that is withdrawn by partners. So partner's capital account amended to cash or bank account, because cash goes out, money goes out, so it should be credited. Okay, fourth one, when new partner does not bring goodwill, is not bringing anything in cash for goodwill, at that time we are adjusting amount of goodwill of new partner against his capital account. Okay, so his capital account should be debited by that much amount. Is that clear? And credited to old partner's capital account. Is that okay? Next one, when new partner bring partial amount of goodwill, means if the goodwill of new partner is say 40,000, he is bringing 10,000 or 15,000 or 20,000, somewhat like that, not the entire 40,000. Okay, so the mixture of previous two methods, one bringing cash, another not bringing cash. Why? Because partial bringing cash, so for that portion, bringing cash pattern, the remaining amount which is not bringing, for that portion, obviously not bringing cash. Okay, so in this case, cash to premium for goodwill for the portion he is bringing. Then second entry, new partner's capital account debited for the portion he is not bringing. Listen carefully, you can make your own notes on this basis. Okay, first entry, cash account debited to premium for goodwill account. Second entry, new partner's capital account debited for the amount he is not bringing. Premium for goodwill account debited, which we wrote in first entry, to old partner's capital account. Is it okay? Fifth method, this was. And the last one, the amount of goodwill is decided on the basis of
capital partners, capital bearers. Into bracket I wrote in my last session, into bracket I wrote hidden goodwill. And in that also I say, when goodwill is hidden, why won't we want to reveal it? जो गुडविल ने कदाच क्यांक छुपाई जवू जोई, hidden goodwill is here. No need to find it out at present. Okay? When we are going to solve that, at that time we are going to clear the concept also. Don't worry. Is that clear? Now, in last session, we solved first method. That was exercise question number 4 and sub question number 1. In that, new partner C decided to pay goodwill privately. Okay? So, we did only 2 entries in that question. First one was for capital, that is cash or bank to seize capital. And second one was for old goodwill. Okay? Now here, for the last time, but let me again give you a reminder. Whenever old goodwill is given in the question, like this. Whenever old goodwill amount means goodwill appeared in the balance sheet at the time of admission. If such words are given, known as old goodwill before the admission, always take care you have to write it off between old partners. It is compulsory. Not only that, I personally suggest that you should do that entry first. Personally, I suggest that you must do that entry first. Even before the capital of new partner. Why is it so? Because that amount was basically already there before the admission. So it's advisable to write that entry first. Is that clear? And if you remember, in last session, in that question, I did that entry wrongly. I did goodwill account debited. Actually, it must be credited. Why is it so? Because goodwill appeared in the book is always having which balance? Goodwill is always having, yes, debit balance. Okay? Why? Because it is always an asset. Clear? So, at the time of admission, we are writing off that old goodwill. And because already having debit balance, to write it off, we have to make a credit entry for goodwill. And debited to old partner's capital account. In old ratio. In old ratio always. Okay? Before we start this, let me give you one or two clarification, and it's extremely important for you people. Yes, please do take care. You can write it down in your notebook, even in the margin as a special topic. Old goodwill, listen carefully. Old goodwill must be distributed in old partners in old ratio only. Here the ratio is extremely important. Okay? Because new goodwill, premium for goodwill, I can say this, even that is also distributed between old partners. So old partner is common in new goodwill, old goodwill, both. But the ratio, old goodwill always in old partners, always in old ratio. Is that clear? In today's session, I'm going to make you aware where the difference is, where you can commit a mistake if you are not writing these rules. Okay, last time, old goodwill, always old partners, always old ratio. Okay, good. Next, premium for goodwill, into bracket you can write new goodwill. Premium for goodwill, into bracket you can write new goodwill, to be distributed between old partners, the same old partners, but now make care, in sacrifice ratio, in sacrifice ratio, if given, or in old ratio. What does it mean? Premium for goodwill, new goodwill, must be distributed between old partners, in old partners, in sacrifice ratio, if given. So first priority is sacrifice ratio. But if no detail related to it is given, then in old ratio. Okay, again, if sacrifice ratio is possible to find out, must be in sacrifice ratio or in old ratio. If it's not possible to find sacrifice, clear? It is one of the most important MCQ or VSQ you can consider. So many times they ask this question. Goodwill brought in by new partner. Question will be like this. Goodwill brought in by new partner is to be distributed in old partners in dash ratio. Option A, old ratio. Option B, new ratio. Option C, sacrifice ratio. Option D, gain ratio. Now, the thing is that you almost in 70-80% of the cases, you will not have the information of sacrifice. So what do you usually use to do? In old ratio. So it is there in your mind that goodwill brought in by new partner must be distributed in old ratio. But actually it's not. If sacrifice is there, it must be in sacrifice. If sacrifice is not there, then and then old ratio. Okay? Is that clear? Now please don't ask me if old ratio is not given. I had that question for 3 years. See, sometimes students' mentality is there. Something is to be asked by hook or crook. So when I say, if sacrifice ratio is given, must be in sacrifice. If not given, then it should be in old ratio. Then a student raised the hand. I said, yes. Sir, if old ratio is also not given, then Baba, when old ratio is not given, it must be equal. But ratio must be there because they are partners. Okay? Is that clear? So only two options. First, compulsory, sacrifice is given, then sacrifice only. If not possible, not given, then old ratio. Is it okay? Sure. Good. And old goodwill, always in old ratio. Okay? No option, this or this, nothing, only old ratio. Clear? Let's continue with the question. Let's continue with the today's session, in which we are going to solve two questions. Yes, two different questions we are going to have. Okay? Now, take care. In both the question, when new partner brought goodwill in cash. When new partner brought goodwill in cash. So in both the question, the things will remain same. Still something different. Then only I am going to solve here, huh? Otherwise, I can say that do it in homework, but no. If a minor change, which is important, definitely we are going to solve in board work only. Okay? Be ready for the question. It is question 4, sub-question 2. Okay, let's go through the question first. A and B are partners in a firm. C is admitted as a new partner for 1/4 share. C brought rupees, listen carefully, go through the words properly. It may be possible, aa jagah ke misunderstanding thai shake. C brought rupees 80,000 as his capital. 80,000 as his capital. And his proportionate share of goodwill in cash. Now his proportionate share, his proportion is 1/4, but what amount he is going to bring, that is not specified. But one more information is given. Goodwill of the firm is valued at rupees 1 lakh. Is there any problem? Two partners or ratio not mentioned. So let's start solving the question. Or ratio, because it is not given, it's always equal. C's share 1/4. Firm's goodwill, C's steps must be written properly to understand how to do further. Firm's goodwill, they say valuation of firm's goodwill is 1 lakh rupees. So firm's goodwill 1 lakh. Therefore, she's goodwill 25,000. How is it? 1 lakh into 1/4. Is that clear? C's capital 80,000. Is there any problem in the question? Sure. See, here you have to take care. If you feel like that C is bringing 80,000 total, then what you will do? Here you will write 55,000. Because out of 80,000, 25,000 is goodwill. Okay? Even, listen carefully, you know me very well. Okay? Even I can make such twist. See, what I have to do? Nothing else. Here there are, C will bring rupees 80,000 as his capital. Instead of that, I wrote somewhat like that. I may give you the words. C brought rupees 80,000 for capital and proportionate share of goodwill. C brought total rupees. I can use the word total also. Total rupees 80,000 for his capital and proportionate share of goodwill. Now in this case, C's goodwill is 25,000. You can find it out on the basis of this. And total he brought 80,000. So out of 80,000, if 25,000 is of goodwill, what about his capital? 55,000. Is that clear? See, you may feel, what's the problem? What's a big deal? But chalo, in long question, you have to prepare a capital account. So in that you are going to write C's capital. If it is wrong, then the difference of capital account will be wrong. And so it will be transferred wrongly in balance sheet. Naturally, even in cash account, it will be wrong because you write wrongly. Everything will be wrong. Only revaluation account is correct. Okay? So in this ratio, maybe possible, your first mistake may cost you 2 to 3 marks. First mistake. So please do take care not to commit even a single mistake. Okay, let's go through. So this line is out. Is that clear? Now the entry is, do this kind of working out also if needed. Normal format, nothing new. First entry. Here old goodwill is not given in the question. Okay? If it is given, then first entry must be of old goodwill. But here it's not given. Clear? So let's start with the entry. The amount brought in by C. Cash or bank account debited 1,05,000. Now how this 1,05,000 comes? From where? It's not written anywhere in the stats. Yeah, 1 lakh is there. But that is the firm's goodwill. How cash or bank is there? It's very, very easy. C brought capital rupees 80,000. At the same time, is bringing goodwill rupees 25,000. So the total of this two is rupees 1,05,000. Okay? Cash or bank account debited 1,05,000. 2, C's capital account 80,000, because it's bringing 80,000 as capital. And premium for goodwill account 25,000. If old goodwill is there, you have to write the word goodwill account. If brought in by partner, you have to write premium for goodwill. Okay, in last session also I said premium means add on value. Vadharani amount, additional amount. Is it okay? This is premium of goodwill. Is it clear? B, very, very simple. See, if you are doing these things in working note, in long question, they are not going to ask any of the short question. So, in long question, if you are doing this in working note, please do take care. There is no need. To write narration. Being lakhvani jarur nathi. Okay? When you are doing it as working. Here, being C brought capital and goodwill in cash. Second entry. That premium of goodwill we have to distribute it in old partners. In old ratio, because no clarification of sacrifice is there. Okay? So premium for goodwill account debited 25,000. 2 is capital account 12,500. 2 B is capital account 12,500. Is it clear? Any problem? 25,000 distributed equally in old ratio. Okay, being goodwill distributed in old partners. If any problem, please feel free to do a tick mark, because at present you can't ask me. Okay, now one thing for this, just before a minute or so, I say that because no clarification of sacrifice, how can we come to know that we are going to find sacrifice or not? Whenever either sacrifice is clearly given, you can easily understand. But if not given, a new ratio is given. See, old ratio is always to be there. Because if not given, it is equal. So old ratio is there in the question, invariably. But whenever new ratio is given in the question, it will be there in so many long questions. So I am suggesting it to do proper knots, to write proper knots for it. Whenever old ratio and new ratio both are given, always we have to find the sacrifice. Because the formula itself says, sacrifice equals to old ratio minus new ratio. when old ratio is available, when new ratio is available, naturally we can and we have to find a sacrifice. If we are not finding sacrifice, we have to sacrifice the marks. Okay, take care. Why I'm telling you so many things in this session? Because this is the question where we are going to have this topic. Okay? In this question also, new partner got Purdue in cash. But the difference between this is, two differences are there. One, old goodwill is given. So we did that entry first, as I say. Second, very important, new ratio is given. Well, it is, here it is. New ratio is given. Old ratio always there. So we have to find out sacrifice. Okay? Is that clear? For this purpose only we do this. Otherwise, nothing new. Is it okay? See the same entry. Cash to seize capital to premium for goodwill. Cash to seize capital to premium for goodwill. Premium for goodwill to A to B. Premium for goodwill to A to B. The similar things are there in both the questions. Why is it so? Just because in both the question, new partner brought goodwill in cash. Bichu no kaish nothing. But very important. One, old goodwill is there. That is also very easy. Second, sacrifice is there. Here it is not. So we did it in old ratio, we divided it in old ratio, we distributed in old ratio. Here it is given. So in sacrifice. That's why we are going to solve this question. Is there any problem? Sure. Let's go to the question. As usual, first of all, we must understand the question properly. First of all, let's go to the question. Here it is, question number 4, sub question 3. A and B are the partners sharing profit and loss in the ratio of 2:3. So that is their old ratio. They admitted C as a new partner. C brought his share in capital and goodwill, ₹40,000 and ₹60,000 cash respectively. Take care. First they use the word capital, so ₹40,000 is for capital, and second goodwill, so ₹60,000 is for goodwill. Overall C is bringing ₹1,00,000, 40 plus 60. At the time of C's admission, the balance of goodwill in the balance sheet of the firm was 30,000. So that is old goodwill already given in the question. Whenever it is there, as I say, you must do the entry first. Okay? And old goodwill always in old ratio only, whether sacrifice is given or not. It is not at all connected with old goodwill. Okay. New profit sharing ratio. In the question further they said, new profit sharing ratio of all partners is decided at 3:5:2. 3:5:2. Is there any problem? Yes, all partners. All partners means including new partner. So old ratio was 2:3, only two partners. New ratio 3:5:2. Let's go through the solution. Here the steps. Old ratio 2:3. C's capital 40,000. C's goodwill 60,000. old goodwill 30,000, new ratio 3:5:2. Clear? Now, maybe one or two students out of you, or maybe more, think like that. How many steps we have to write? Sir, if in working note, we have to write all this, when can we complete the question? When can we complete the solution now? Don't worry. In working note, you are not supposed to write everything. Okay? In working note, you are going to do the entry for premium for goodwill only. Is that clear? So there is no need to write so many things. Don't worry. And then, when you are going to solve long questions, at that time, I will do working note also. So if you compare, you can come to know that only one or two steps and one or two entries. Okay? Then why we are doing all this at present? Because that one or two entries are among them. The method will remain same. So if you don't understand this properly, again let me tell you which I said in last lecture, that goodwill is one of the most important topic. When I am using the word important, maybe you can consider it as twist or tough topic. If you are not going to do regular practice. Okay, after today's session, what you should do? We should do practice of all three sessions, all three methods, I'm sorry. First one, paid privately. Second, normal retail in the business. Third, sacrifice ratio is to be found out. All three you must practice. In next session, again two or three methods. Then all five or six. Okay? Let's go through. So here, old ratio is given 2:3. New ratio is given 3:5:2. And please take care, you can write it down in your book. Whenever both the ratios are given, always you have to find sacrifice. Clear? Sacrifice equals old ratio minus new ratio, the formula. Naturally, only old partners are sacrificing. So for A and B only, A 2/5 on the basis of this, minus 3/10 on the basis of this. B 3/5 minus 5/10. Overall 15, 20 minus 15 comes to 5/15. Nothing else, simple LCM. Here also 5 into 10, 50. 10 3s are 30, 5 5s are 25, 5/50. Even you can write 1/10. Okay? So indirectly we can say that sacrifice is 1/10, 1/10. But that sacrifice ratio is 1:1. When you are taking numerators only, it will give you ratio format. Okay? For the entries, journal entries in the books of normal format, I am not going to say anything for this. First entry, always take that. See, it is not compulsory, but always, whenever goodwill is given, you must do first entry of it. Okay, if you do this entry over here, first, second, and then third, nobody is going to cut your marks. Don't worry about it. But what happened? In this, when you are applying sacrifice ratio, maybe possible, while doing this entry over here, you may feel, you may tempt, in hurry, you may forget, utavarna bhuli jasho, that old must be in old ratio only. So if you distributed it in sacrifice ratio, it would be wrong. And so I am suggesting, always, whenever old goodwill is given, first entry must be of that. So A is capital account debited, B is capital account debited, to goodwill account. This is the correct entry, don't worry. Okay? Because goodwill always having debit balance, this is the entry of writing of goodwill.
So it should be credited with the same amount divided between the partners in the old ratio 2:3. So 12,000, 18,000 and 30,000. Is that clear? See, I didn't write being, but you can write being old goodwill distributed or reconciled, old goodwill written off and distributed between partners, between old partners. Okay? Second, cash or bank account debited. Cash or bank account debited. 1 lakh. Why 1 lakh? Because 40,000 plus 60,000. Cash or bank account debited 1 lakh. 2. Seize capital account. Take care. By mistake, if you write 60 over here, 40 over here. Again, committing a mistake. You may feel, sir, it's not possible. I saw that kind of papers. And so I am saying. But when we are committing mistakes, naturally it's not intentionally. So you are not aware about that. Sometimes we feel, how is it possible? But just due to little bit overconfidence or carelessness. To seize capital 40,000, to premium for goodwill 60,000. Is that clear? Okay. And the last entry, premium for goodwill is to be distributed between old partners. But most important matter, the difference between previous question and this question. Difference between previous question, previous does not mean previous session. Here previous question means this one. See, here also the entry, the particular will remain same. In this question as well as in this question. But the difference is, here we distributed in old ratio. Whether here we are distributing it in sacrifice ratio. The old ratio is 2:3. But we are distributing this 60,000 in 1:1. Okay? Sacrifice ratio. In being, you can write being goodwill brought in by C distributed in old partners in that sacrifice or in that sacrifice ratio. You can write. Is it okay? A very important point. Take care. With this reason only, I do this two questions simultaneously. Why? Because you can compare the entry will remain same 2 and 3 over here 1 and 2. But the big difference is here, because sacrifice is not given old ratio only, here sacrifice new ratio is given. So can find sacrifice, and because we can find sacrifice, always it should be distributed in sacrifice ratio only. Okay? At last, two or three important topics from this session. In first question, that is actually exercise for second question, we find amount of seized goodwill on the basis of firm's total goodwill. Okay, so that is something new. Seized goodwill directly it is not given. So we find 25,000. At the same time, we did total of 80,000 and 25,000 while doing the entry of cash or bank. Okay, so you have to take care that this you have to find as well as this time you have to do the total of this. Is that clear? Okay, nothing new in this. In this question, one thing, that is old goodwill is given, must be distributed first between old partners in old ratio only. Second, old ratio, new ratio, both are given. Whenever both are given, or any other information of sacrifice is given, it will be later on. We'll solve that kind of questions also, don't worry. So whenever both the ratios are given, always you have to find sacrifice, and goodwill must be distributed in that sacrifice ratio. Okay? So, by using the formula of SUN, that is sacrifice equals old ratio minus new ratio, we
we find sacrifice, and it is 1:1. Then the entries, in entry, nothing new except one additional entry for goodwill. Okay? That is old goodwill. The remaining two entries, particular wise, there is no change. The only change that in next, second question, we distributed goodwill in sacrifice ratio. First, it was in old ratio. Is there any problem? Questions, queries, confusion? Nothing? Sure? Think twice. Bevakat vichare lo. Then and then tell me. Are you sure that you are not having any problem? Good. Now, let me tell you that next question, that is exercise 4, question number 4. Is it possible for you to solve it out? Go through it. By just going through the question itself, I'm sure majority of you say no. Why? Because of the question they give, furniture and motor car, cash, so many things. So you will, no sir, it's not our cup of tea. Okay, don't worry. Yeah, I know that. Few of the students, very few, maybe 15-20% students said yes, let's try. But I cannot work for that 15% students only now. I wish that if you do proper practice, if you are having confidence, after 3, 4, 5 sessions, when I am going to ask a similar type of question, that can you solve the next one? Sure, at least 70-80% student may say yes. Because if you do proper practice, if you go through the question properly, you will find that yes, we can do it. And we can do it. These are the magical words. Okay? So if you try, yes, you can do everything. But if you try, if you fail, that's great. Because again you can try. Again fail, that's great. Again you can try. Try and try, you will succeed. Okay? But for next question, that is question number 4, I'm not saying that it is in homework, because if you committed a single mistake, your classwork may get disturbed. But let me say, you can do it. So if any one of you would like to try, definitely you can solve it in your rough book. Don't feel that it's a laborious work, that once you do it in rough book and then in fair book, it's always a matter of practice. The students, passed out students, I can give you reference of 3, 4, 5, 10, 15 students who did everything in rough work when we used to teach in classroom. And then they do the same thing in classwork at home. They have to spare additional time. But they consider it as practice. And so, that is one of the secret behind their great success. Okay? They are doing one more time the same things, which majority of you are not doing. So it all depends on you. If you want to do practice like that, yes, you can solve next question in your rough book. You may get definitely a topic where you may feel confused, but don't worry. I'm sure if you go through it properly, you can solve the entire question. For the remaining, don't worry. We are going to solve that question also in our next session. Okay? If the question is in homework, I will tell you clearly. For this question, I am saying, you can try by your own if you want to. If you don't want to, naturally, I cannot do force for it. It's purely voluntarily. Okay? So in next session, be ready for solving one or two more different questions with some additional topics. Till then, continue practicing all three questions of goodwill. And don't forget to go through that PNR ratio questions, at least orally. Once in a day, go through all questions, different patterns. Okay? So, till next session, take care of yourself, make others happy, and you too also be happy.